One of the questions that comes up a lot, or perhaps this one's a complaint about model-driven apps, is why can't my users just do their data entry line by line, row by row? They don't want to have to click new and go in and open it and enter all the data and click save. I get it. There is an answer to this. There is a built-in feature that seems to be very little known about. And so today we're going to talk about the Edit in Excel Online feature. This works in both model-driven Power Apps and the Dynamics 365 customer engagement apps. It's exactly the same. So I'm going to do one example in a model-driven app to start with of entering data, and then we'll switch across and do the same thing in a Dynamics application for updating data. And then I'm also going to show you how you can even use Excel formulas inside this experience. It's a little bit hidden away inside my model-driven app here. Depending on your zoom factor, you may or may not see it. So I've got a fairly high zoom here. In the three dots, you'll find Export to Excel, and in that menu there, you want Open in Excel Online. If your zoom is a little bit down, you'll see the Export to Excel already in the ribbon. Same thing, you just need to find that and click Open in Excel Online. Now, this is not taking you away from your application. It's basically just bringing up that view with all the data in, guess what, Excel. What this is technically doing is sort of an export and re-import without the user having to actually deal with that or know about that. So I've got everything here. Let's do the first example of wanting to do some data entry. So let's say I've got a recruitment application here. I have got a bunch of new roles that we're ready to recruit for. So what I can do is just come down here underneath and start typing in Excel. So let's say I've got account manager Sydney. That's a text column, but this next one here for department is actually a choice column, and you'll see if I scroll down a bit here that it's going to force me to do the data entry based on the choices. So that's sales. I can choose my level, and you'll see here this is a whole number, so we're going to put level one in here, and this is going to be an open role ready to go. Now let's say I needed to actually recruit for three of these. I can just grab this, drag it down, and we're good. Now you'll see it's doing that Excel-like experience there of filling with the calculation, which I don't want it to do. So you can just do all of that data entry. You could also, if you had it already in a spreadsheet and you didn't want to do some kind of actual import, you could be copying and pasting across here as well. When I'm done, I can just click save, and that will take a second and process in the background. Now, what you get here is an option. You don't have to do this. I like to do it, but you can click on track progress, and this will now give you a history of what's happened and where it's up to. But if you just want to get on with things, you can just click cancel if you're confident that you don't need to do any error checking, and just get on with your day and you're all done. You can see here that I've got one that I did earlier where there are some errors in there. So you can actually click through that to have a look at what's happened with the errors and have another go. What will happen here is we'll go through the process of submitted, I think it goes past is the next one. Oh, there we go. It wasn't very many rows and completed. And you can see I've got three successes and all fine. We'll come back here. Let's refresh this view. And there we go. Account manager, Sydney, Sydney, Sydney. And they're all sitting in there. It's also as the owner, because I'm the person who's doing this data entry, automatically created that as me as the owner. I will come back and show you how you can get back into that data import screen. First, I want to show you the experience of updating things. So I'm switching across to Dynamics 365 Sales. If you're not a Dynamics user, don't worry. All the same experience. You'll see how this works. So again, within the Dynamics menu, if you don't see it there, just use the three dots, Export to Excel, and Open in Excel Online. So my scenario here is that I've got some opportunities that I'm working on in the pipeline, and I need to come through and update all of these dates because I've been a bit slack, as if any salesperson would ever do this. So I've got my estimated close date, and some of these are very much in the past, and my sales manager is not delighted. I can just come here and make these changes. So we're just going to push all of these out a year, which is a bit cheeky, but you'll get the idea. So you can see I'm working with dates here, which is a little bit different from what I did before. And when I'm finished, I can just click on that save button. And this time I'm just going to click cancel to return to my work and go on with it. And when I refresh the screen, that will come up. Now, before I show you how you can use formulas in here, let's take a look at how you get that import screen back. Let's say I click that cancel button and I didn't mean to, or it hasn't worked and I want to track it down. In either of Dynamics or your model-driven Power App, you'll have this settings icon. and you want to click through here into advanced settings. I'm showing it in the model driven app just because there's fewer options here, and also I'm logged in as a user who is not an administrator, just to show that you can do this. So you're going back to a bit of a legacy interface here. You're going to go up into the settings menu and click here on data management. And then from here, you want to have a look at imports. So as I said earlier, what this is effectively doing is giving you an experience of export import without you realizing it. So that's where you'll find it. And then I can come in here and click through onto that and pop up and get visibility on what's going on there. Now, I've promised you some action with Excel formulas here. So let's say, now this is a bit dodgy because you would never actually do it like this, but I've got a whole lot of blank data here with my levels. And because this is demo data and I can do what I like, I'm actually going to put a random value in here just to show you an example of how this will work. So what I've got, when I click in that column there, I've actually got access to my formula bar, same as I would have in Excel. So I'm going to use a rand formula here, which returns a random number. So I'm going to say that we want, in fact, sorry, I want the rand between. I've even got some of my built-in help here. I want this to be 1 and 5. So I want to generate a random number between 1 and 5, and we will click that. There we go. And then I can just take that and drag that all the way down. Let's just write over the top of all of those other ones that were already in there. And there we go. Once I save that, that formula won't be there anymore. That formula is just used in Excel. That's just writing into that data field to put that number directly in there. Let's cancel that. And we come back after a minute or so, click on that refresh icon, and you have got all of that data in there. Please give this video a like if you found it helpful, and more tips here on things you might not know how to do with your model-driven apps.